Welcome back. Let's do this. You know how it goes, based on the facts and the facts only. That gentleman at the top on the left is the current mayor. The fellow on the right is the union president, who happens to be the respondent superior, who also happens to be a hospital police captain under special officer. All right? So we're going to go to this document right here, okay, when they brought a request for disciplinary actions, and they want to go all the way down to termination, as you read, all right. But the key facts in this document is the fact that the date is not correct. See that December 9th, when it happened December 11th. And the time is not correct, where it says 23:55 when it happened at 23:45. So that would make this document a fraudulent document. That would make it in violation of their own corporate compliance policy, page number 47 out of 49, where it goes under that violation of New York State Penal Law Code 17500, false written statement. All right, this would be 175 subsection 17530. All right, because they offered this false written statement to file on the record. Now the key thing is, you see over there on the right, on the bottom, it says shifting the burden of persuasion under civil service law, which is your burden of proof. This cannot be false. You can't use that when going to 40 rector, when you're going to arbitration, all right, when you're going to take disciplinary actions. You can't use that. So based on this information, it brings about that question of why he terminated his representatives down here. But yet, the union grievance coordinator still couldn't figure it out, who happens to be a litigations attorney, who's also under oath, as well as the captain, who's the union president, who's under oath. Like I said, you got to use what they used against you back against them and hold them under the oath of office. All right? And I'm out later.